The core of every spreadsheet is a grid. These columns are all letters, so you have ABC, and then the rows are numbers, 1, 2, 3. And then inside where those two intersect, so we'll look at B2, so B and 2, we'll click on that. That makes B2 the active cell, and that's how you would reference it when you're building a formula. Let's just go up in A1 and start it up here. We'll say name, so that's the item name, and we'll call it type. And then we'll say the quantity, and then we'll say the price, right? This is a spreadsheet, it's all about money. Okay, so you have to have a price in there. And then we'll say total, because that's going to be quantity times the price. And to do some formatting, we'll left click on the number 1, that'll select the entire row, and we'll just turn those headers bold, and that'll make it a little bit easier to see that it's a table. And then we will change the alignment to center. And now let's add some actual data into here. So the types of inventory, we'll say it's a shovel, we'll say a rake, and a trowel. And there'll be 4 shovels, 6 rakes, and you have a lot of trowels for some reason, a dozen trowels. But you want to know the value of your inventory, right? That's one of the main reasons why you're doing this. And in this case, to get the value, you want to multiply the quantity times the price. We have to tell this formula where those values are. So you want to multiply the 4. Well, that's in B2, right? So we just type B2, or let me backspace. I can just click on B2 with my mouse and it will put that in there. And now we're going to use an operator. So in this case, it's going to be an asterisk, whatever. It's going to be a star. So I did Shift-8. And this, so that's telling Google Sheets to multiply B2. And we're going to say multiply that by C2. So now we're getting a little preview of the value. And you'll notice something else going on. And this is to help you visualize what's happening. B2 is orange. And the value of B2 is surrounded by an orange dotted line. Same with C2, so you get purple and you have purple. When you get a more complex formulas and you're picking values out from around the spreadsheet, this can help you to see what's going on. And now we're ready to hit enter. And we've done our first formula that's coming up with the total price. And pay attention closely to this next thing that we're going to do, because this is kind of separating the power of a spreadsheet just from a calculator. Because we use cell references, you can copy D2 and you can paste it into D3 and D4, and it shifts down and does the multiplication for the appropriate row. All right, so we've built our first formulas. Now we're going to do a little bit of formatting. So we can do a couple things right now. We're going to select the range of C2 through D4, and we'll change this to currency formatting because these are in the United States, so these are in dollars. So that helps us to see what type of units we're using. And then let's also mark the bottom of the table. So this is A4 through D4, and we're going to apply a bottom border. So we'll left click on bottom border, and note that that's not a text underline. It's different. So this formatting stays with the cell. It's not assigned to the text. So try to do that instead of underlining. And now this table is a little bit easier to look at. As a matter of fact, I'm going to zoom in on it a little bit because we don't have a whole lot going on in this spreadsheet. So we'll say 150%. All right, now we're going to do another formula. We'll introduce a few more concepts. What we want to do is just sum the values in D2 through D4. Relatively simple. So we could do it the way we did the multiplication. We could hit the equal sign. We could point to D2 plus D3 plus D4. That works. It's using operators. It's not using a function. But what we want to do is introduce a concept of a function and a cell range here. that's going to help you and to take it to the next level and work with larger sets of data. So to insert this, we'll do it the way that's good for someone that's new to spreadsheets. So I would have this memorized. I would hit an equal sign and type sum. You just type the formula directly in. But the better way to learn is to go to insert, select function. And the most common five are at the top. We want to do sum. You could also find this if you went to math and scroll down and found sum there. Okay, but let's go up to where it's easiest. We'll click on sum. And you get the formula help here. You can expand that down if you need to see more. And this is telling you, you type out sum, you add the parentheses, which that did for us, and now it's waiting for the values. All right, and I said that we're going to use the concept of a cell range now inside of this function. So what we will do, we're going to select D2, but keep on dragging, hold your mouse down, go all the way down to D4. So we're doing all of this summing without pointing to each individual cell. All right, so we're going to hit enter, and you'll notice that that formula would be the same length if it referred to 3 cells or 300 cells, because all you would do for the 300 cells is change the ending row number on the range. Okay, we'll hit enter. Let's do a little styling on this. We'll make that bold to denote that that's the bottom of the table of data. And so when we look at this table of data, there are different data types inside of it. So for example, this quantity that's 4, someone comes into the spreadsheet and just types out 4 thinking that will work. It will break the result of the formula because this is not a value, this is text. All right, so it's important to learn that. We'll change that back to 4. And I'm touching a little bit on the data types because I want to talk about some additional types that you can use to help you out in your spreadsheet. So there's one called Boolean where it's true or false, kind of a yes or no. We'll say needs ordering question mark. And that'll be if we need more of this type of item. And we're going to insert a checkbox. So you can use this checkbox. Let me copy this down. But it's a data type that only has 2 answers. It's a false, which is an empty box, or let's say we need to order rakes, it becomes a true. So a data type like this could be handy where you want to say yes or no to something. So if you come down to row 3 and there's a checkbox in it, maybe you want some sort of conditional formula here to show how much you need to order. And that'll lead to another type of concept that Google has introduced recently, which is these connections to other places within Google where you have information. These are called smart chips, and they can connect to other places in Google where you have information stored. So there's all different types, and what we're going to try right now is a place chip. And of course, because our inventory has tools, we're going to look up a hardware store. And when you enter smart chip, you start with the at symbol. So I'll type one here, and we'll say the hardware store is at 123 William Street, New York, just because that's what came up first. So maybe the person using this spreadsheet needs to drive over to get the shovels. If you put this link into the spreadsheet, that will give you some information about the address. Google Maps will load up in the sidebar after you click it, and this will tell that person how to get there. We made it all the way through this video in less than 10 minutes. And now instead of creating your own sheet, you should just watch this next video. It's more on those smart chips and how to extract data from them. I'll see you in that video. Thanks for watching.